In America, a 17-year-old boy is charged with killing two members of his own family. He's obsessed with a violent new movie.
Eeny, meeny, miny, moe.
This weekend, the film Natural Born Killers opened in London. But can fictional screen violence cause real-life aggression? Railroad line outside Salt Lake City, Utah, USA. Bryant Hamblin used to meet his friend Nathan here. Nathan Martinez, the teenager who loved Natural Born Killers, now facing trial on two charges of murder.
I still don't want to believe it, but I guess I have to because, I don't know, he's my best friend and all, and I just don't want to. You know, every kid once in their life has said, I wish I could kill my parents, but they never do it. They never even come close to doing it. And then when he did it, I guess I just kind of, I was more of a shock for like a week or so, and then finally it hit me, you know, oh my God, he did it.
He's dead! He's dead!
Now where's the old bag?
He's dead! He's dead!
He thought it was great. He just loved it. Got him, just got him all psyched up, you know, and He just loved it. He just thought it was great.
In the movie, Mickey and Mallory kill her parents who've abused her and bid her brother goodbye.
Free Kevin.
Immediately after killing his own stepmother and his half-sister, Nathan Martinez drove round to his best friend's house.
I just heard a knocking at my window, and I knew it was him, and I was worried because he'd said it before, and I just didn't want to believe that he did it.
Bryant had known Nathan right through high school. They saw Natural Born Killers together. Bryant saw it once, but Nathan went back and saw it 10 times over. Nathan took Bryant with him for a ride. Once they were on the road, Nathan told him he was on the run from a double murder.
Like he'd say, like in the movie, Mickey and Mallory were in the car driving, and he'd look over at me and say, he'd say, just like in the movie, you know, Mickey and Mallory, you know, only this time it's Nathan and Bryant. And I just kind of cringe because he's trying to make me a part of his little fantasy, and I didn't want to have anything to do with it.
When I look up at the stars, I know you're looking up at the same ones.
Same ones, baby.
You make every day feel like kindergarten.
He kept on saying it was fake, how they died, and it's not like in the movies. And he just kept on saying they're dead, they're just dead.
It was early the next morning when Nathan and Bryant arrived in the small town of Logan, set just below the Rocky Mountains. There, Nathan paid a visit to another close school friend, James Fike, who'd been to see Natural Born Killers with them. Now, for the first time, Nathan revealed exactly what he'd done.
He told me that he'd loaded up his .22, went up to his half-sister's room, and he just pulled up the gun up to her head and shot her. He told me that she'd, like, curled up into the fetal position. And then he raced down the hall and kicked open. He raced up the hall and kicked open his stepmother's room and stepped in there, and she was trying to get out of bed because she had heard the gunshot, and he shot her in the head and she just fell forward. He might have thought to himself, you know, these guys glamorized it. They got away with it.
You ain't seen nothing yet.
He might have just, without really thinking, thought to himself, all right, the movie did it this way. This is how I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna go up there and just like beat him up, shoot him.
Nathan drove to the local music store and bought the soundtrack of Natural Born Killers. His friends left him, James Fike alerted the police, and like his screen idols, Nathan went back on the run.
Of evidence authorities seem most concerned about recovering were found right in the trunk of this car stolen from Martinez's father. Also seized from the car, various items of clothing and a compact disc of a movie soundtrack.
I just think personally that he thought that his problems were so bad that he had to find a way out, and I think the movie helped him connect to find this way out.
We don't know where reality and fantasy breaks down, but I believe that there's something there that, if you want to call it an excuse, a reason, or something that he could strongly identify with. And like Sergeant Townsend alluded to earlier, that the movie kind of ends with him driving off into the sunset. And I think it, he felt that, you know, as each passing day, that he probably had accomplished what he wanted to accomplish and thought that he possibly would get away with it.
Most people are equipped to see movies. I cannot, of course, talk for lunatics, people who accept movies at face value and believe exactly what they see on the screen and then go out and do something. That category of person is a person who is easily suggestible, could be brainwashed, could take could smoke a marijuana cigarette and go out and shoot somebody just as easily, or just take acid and jump out a window. There are those type of people. Film is a powerful medium. Film is a drug. Film is a potential hallucinogen. It goes into your eye, it goes into your brain. It stimulates, and it's a dangerous thing. It can be a very subversive thing.